Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Monday night edition of Insider Financial Talk Stocks. My name is Alex Carlson. I will be your host today, the editor-in-chief of InsiderFinancial.com. And in this video, we will recap Tuesday's market action and discuss our trading plan for tomorrow. But first, if you want our free alerts, click that link in the description or go to signup.InsiderFinancial.com or sign up on any of the pop-ups on InsiderFinancial.com. It is completely free, guys. Unsubscribe anytime. Once you sign up with your email, you can then sign up with your mobile number. Mobile is the fastest way to get all of our alerts, and it works for all numbers worldwide. Simply enter your country code first, followed by your number. For US and Canada, it'd be 1 plus area code and number. Never begin the format with 0. It will not work. And then after you sign up, you will get a welcome email, which includes a free copy of the Insider Financial Guide to Penny Stocks ebook. This ebook talks about all the strategies that I go over in my videos. And again, it is completely free. Our ebook, our email service, and our text messaging services are all free services from InsiderFinancial.com. We do not run any paid subscription service whatsoever, no Discord rooms, no Telegram chat rooms whatsoever. But first, before we dive into today's market action, I want to recap our recent alerts. Last Monday, we had an OTC alert for subscribers only that I didn't talk about on this channel. It opened at 18 cents and closed at 22 cents today. This morning, we had a NASDAQ alert that opened just above $5 and closed below $5.50. We are 2 for 2 over the past 2 weeks. The only way to get these plays is by signing up for free. Click that link in the description or go to signup.insiderfinancial.com. One nice runner that we had from the channel that I gave last week was HEPA. Talked about it on the Tuesday night video. It opened on Wednesday just above 50 cents. Today it closed at 106, was as high as 119. Congrats to all that played HEPA and got in this play. But today, I didn't do any trading. There were just no real catalysts to drive prices. We had the Empire State Manufacturing Index came in negative, worse than expected. It's is second worst record, worst recording on record. First was during COVID times, which is bearish, but the market could interpret it that the Fed's policies are actually working and that the Fed is going to have to pause. So again, there was just not a lot to drive prices today. If you look at the SPY today, opened at 398, ran into resistance at 400, pulled back to 397, and just chopped around. Again, guys, the key is identifying each day. You want to look at what stocks are in play, what is the news, what is the catalyst, what is going to drive prices. And right now, you need that catalyst, or you're not going to make money in this market. You know, case in point, let's look at MGOL. This is the one everyone was talking about on retail. Moon Market, friend of the channel, good guy. He is great for, you know, sentiment and, you know, what retail is talking about. And he had a tweet, you know, MGOL is on retail's radar. It's been near the top of new watchers on stock twits all weekend. And he is 100% correct. And that was the case. And we were watching it. I was watching it to see if there was a trade today. And again, guys, I talk about this in the ebook. I talk about the opening range. This was the opening range for MGOL. I never do anything at the open. It's like a prize fight. You want the fighters to come into the ring, square off. Let's see how, you get a sense of the other fighter, or you can, if you're watching, you get a sense of who you think is, you want to make your bet on. And it opened at 542, dipped down to 525. I watched it. It was just like, just trading right between 540, and then the market just took off. And then within 4 minutes, we got the trading halt. And I was like, well, this thing might really run today. Because, you know, retail, it was all they were talking about. And it was just, you know, I'll talk about it in another play. But, you know, some of the comments on, you know, that on FinTwit and on StockTwits, I mean, guys, a lot of people are just pumping stocks. I don't know if they're paid pumpers or, you know, they're in their play and they think it's going to contribute to the play running. There's just so many games going on in FinTwit that you just, you know, you got to ignore the noise, but you also have to know what everyone's talking about. And then if you know that a play is, if a stock is in play, it's learning how to trade it. And this is what I'm talking about and trying to help you guys. So here's the opening range, as I said. Opened at 542, dipped down to 525, and then ran to 670. And then on this is the first 15 minutes. The 15 minute is the opening range that I like. Some people like 10 minutes, some people like 5 minutes. Whatever, to each his own. You got to develop what works for you. And then at the on the next 15 minute bar, it opened at 624, was as high as 644, and then dropped to $5. So this play was done. The first 15 minutes were the only play. So if you bought at the open, sold, you know, after the halt, you made money. You know, there is, but again, I'm not looking to do that type of trade. That to me, that's gambling. I want to, you know, take less swings, wait for that right pitch, wait for the right setup. If I miss a play, fine. It doesn't bother me. You know, and I think that's the key. I don't have any FOMO. I don't get into all that. And if you really want to be successful long term, you have to do that. But right now, you know, retail is just getting, you know, effing bagged. I can't even, you know, if you look at the plays right now, you know, a lot of plays that a lot of retail in, they're just getting bagged. And if you look at this whole MGOL, you know, and I didn't talk about it this weekend because I don't want to bash. I don't want to say bash, but it's like, you know, bring to light, you know, hurt some people's bubble or whatever. But, you know, MGOL, I mean, Messi isn't even a shareholder. He gets 12% of revenues. And if you look at the, you know, it has Ginny Hilfiger, you know, she's the youngest sibling of fashion designer Tommy Hilfiger, you know, she's a co-founder. But if you, you know, just did, you know, 2 minutes of work, you realize that this is a dumpster fire. You know, it says here, however, it's unclear if Messi's popularity can help the company financially rebound. The company reported declining yearly revenues for the first three quarters of 2022. After posting revenue of $557,000 in the first 9 months of 2021, revenues fell to $336,000 for the first 9 months of 2022. There is substantial doubt regarding our ability to continue as an ongoing concern as a result of our historical recurring losses and negative cash flows from operations, as well as our dependence on private equity and financing, the company conceded when addressing risks in its filings. So, I mean, everyone's focused on, you know, if Messi is going to talk about it on social media. You know, he's one of the most followed people in the world. If he does, then you're going to get that move. I have no idea if he ever is or what. But again, it's just right now, there's just a lot of pain and retail is feeling this. And, you know, I get the sense, you know, I've traded a lot of plays. I mean, you had Kala, which was the Martin Shkreli biotech. You had GameStop, AMC, Bed Bath & Beyond, Trump SPAC, DWAC, Kodak, you know, TSMP, ENZC. You know, so I know when a stock is hot and there's bullish enthusiasm. And you know, stock just runs right now, that we're just not in that market right now. And, you know, case in point is GVSI. You know, Canadians that were able to buy when the stock was expert market, they dumped today. They took their profits. You know, FinTwit, you know, just the insane stuff today. Honest question for you who sold GVSI today. Why take profits now when the most important catalysts haven't even occurred yet? Are you just broke? It's like, you know, the crypto bros were just telling everybody, you know, have fun, you know, being poor. You know, here's another one. Who is selling today in the USA, throwing away a year and a half wait and their 0% long-term capital gain tax benefit? Certainly nobody I know. I don't know anybody that clueless. Whoever picked up shares today made the buy of a lifetime. Congratulations to you. I mean, this scares the sh- you know, whenever I see stuff like this, and this is what people are talking about, you know, you want to run from this type of stuff. Again, GVSI can, you know, there's a lot of catalysts coming, so we'll see. But again, the price action was horrible. And I said, I talked about it in the weekend video. I said one OTC to watch this week. You know, you had George Sharp canceling shares and talking about it. Again, what is the opening range? This is the opening range. Opened just under 5 cents, and dumped right away. The stock was, you know, sold off from there. So again, playing the opening range kept you out of this play today. So again, we'll be watching it this week. I will be updating, and we go from there. You know, it's one day. You know, tomorrow's another day, another trading day. There are going to be plenty of opportunities, and if there isn't, you scratch it off and wait for that right pitch. Some news in the after hours: SDC, Smile Direct Club, they put out a press release. They're cost cutting and trying to save conserve cash. Stock bidding up in the after hours. Almost 20% of the float is short, so this is a potential short squeeze play. So we'll be watching this one tomorrow. Moderna out with news. They have their RSV vaccine was a success. This has just been a their RSV vaccine trial success. This stock has been a great trader. It can play with options. A lot of opportunity in Moderna. So again, I'll be watching this one for trade setups. But again, in the morning, we'll be doing screens. If we see anything, you know, interesting for our subscribers, we will send out a full report and let you know what we think. So the only way to get that is by clicking the link in the description, or go to signup.insiderfinancial.com, or sign up on any of the pop-ups on insiderfinancial.com. And again, guys, it is a completely free service. With that way, finally, I just want to say, Insider Financial and myself are not investment advisors. This video does not provide investment advice. Always do your own research, make your own investment decisions, or consult your nearest financial advisor. This video is not a solicitation or recommendation to buy, sell, or hold securities. This video is our opinions meant for informational and educational purposes only, and does not provide investment advice. Thanks for watching. Also, remember to smash that like button, hit the notification bell to be notified when a new video is uploaded. Good luck, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.